Hello, Pinky. Good afternoon.
Hello, teacher.
Yes. Okay. So thank you so much for showing up today, even though that I just confirmed that I can make it today, and it was a last minute confirmation, but you still show up. I appreciate that one, Pinky. So how's everything going with you, Pinky?
It is quite good.
Very good. Okay, how's the weather there?
It is cloudy and cool.
Oh, wow. It's similar here in my place. So, how was your exam last week, Pinky?
I haven't known the score yet. So I don't know whether it was good or not.
Okay. So yeah, me too. I just finished my interview earlier and I'm still waiting for the result. Yeah, hopefully we'll get positive results with what we're looking forward to. Okay, but anyway, last week, if you can remember, I asked you to read a story and you did great in writing a story. So it was actually about Olivia. So this is what the story that you continued. Okay, the beginning of the story is Olivia read a message from her friend and smiled. All right, can you still remember the continuation of your story that you make in this part, Pinky?
Yes.
All right, very good. So we also have a sample answer. So what are you going to do is you're going to read the example answer and answer the questions from 1 to 6 in here. Okay, so let's look at number one. Where and when does most of the action happen? Okay, two, who are the main characters and what is their relationship? Three, what is the situation? So that is the setting. Four, what problem do the characters have? Five, how is this problem solved? And how does the story end? Okay, so don't forget about those questions. Here is the sample answer. Could you please read it loudly, Pinky?
Olivia read the message from her friend and smiled. She was excited because Ellie, who lived abroad, was coming to visit her this Friday. Just as Olivia reached the airport to pick up Ellie, she received a call. "There's thick fog here and my plane can't take off," explained Ellie. She received a call. "There's thick no, it's been Ellie. I'm not sure what happened. I'm really disappointed," replied Olivia. As Olivia waited at the airport, she became quite miserable. But then Ellie called again. The sky cleared, she said. 3 hours later, Olivia was delighted when Ellie's plane had finally landed. Ellie said, "It's fantastic to see you."
All right, so let's go back to question number one, Pinky. Where and when does most of the action happen?
There was a thick fog, and Ellie's flight couldn't take off.
All right, so most of the story happened at the airport. Very good. Okay, now who are the main characters and what is their relationship with each other?
What is the answer?
Okay, for number one. Okay, the answer for number one is most of the action of the story happened at the airport. Okay, so what about in question number two? Who are the main characters and what is their relationship?
Main characters are Olivia and Ellie They are friends.
That is right. Very good. Okay, now let's look at number three. What is the situation described in the story?
I have to see the question.
Here it is.
Oh, Alice was going to Olivia's house, but there was a thick fog, so her flight almost be canceled, but she, finally Ellie came to Olivia's house.
That's right. Very good. Okay, so they were planning to meet each other. Very good. Okay, so what problem do the characters have?
Ellie have Alice have a problem with her flight because of the thick fog.
That's right. Okay, so what about Olivia? Does she have any problem in the story?
No.
Very good. Okay, it was only Ellie. Okay, so how about number five? How was the problem solved?
After the sky was clear, and the flight went on.
That's right. Very good. Okay, so how does the story end?
The Ellie successfully came to Olivia's house.
Very good. Okay, so well done, Pinky. Even though that your answers are not the right word per word, but still the thought of it is the same to the answers. It is because you understand the story. So well done for that one, Pinky. How about you, Pinky? Have you ever picked up someone at the airport?
No.
Oh, okay. Do you have any friend who live overseas?
I don't have friends who live overseas, but my cousin lives overseas and he sometimes visits me.
All right. How do you feel whenever your cousin visits you in Vietnam?
What?
How do you feel whenever your cousin visits you in Vietnam?
I feel happy, and my cousin always bring chocolates for me when he comes back to Vietnam.
Oh wow, yes, that is also what I'm looking forward to whenever my relative will come back home from another country, the chocolates or what we call Toblerone. Are you familiar with Toblerone, Pinky?
No.
Oh no. Yeah, that is actually one of the common chocolate that my relatives would bring whenever they come back home. Okay. So, how close are you to your cousin who live overseas, Pinky?
No.
I'm sorry, Pinky.
Can you ask again because my network is not good, so I can't hear.
All right. How close are you to your cousin who live overseas?
Yes, at the average level, but he always brings me chocolate, and I'm very happy. And love my cousin.
Wow, very good. So that means you're very close to her or him. How old is your cousin?
He was born in 20. No, he is now 20 years old.
Oh, so older than you, right? So he's probably in 2004, right? Born in 2004.
Yes.
Okay. So what is his nationality, Pinky?
He is Vietnamese.
Oh, okay. And which country is he now?
He is in Australia.
Wow, great. Okay, so do you have any plans to visit your cousin in Australia?
No, because I don't have money, so I can't book a flight to Australia.
Yes, that's one of the most practical reason, but who knows in the future you can afford it. Okay. But anyway, I want you to look at this story again, Pinky. Then circle the four adjectives that describe the feelings of Olivia. What are those four adjectives?
Excited.
Say that again.
Excited.
Excited. Very good.
Disappointed.
Disappointed. That's right.
Miserable.
Miserable. Let me see. Yes. Okay. And one more.
Delighted.
Delighted. Very good. Okay. I want you to look at those four adjectives. So which adjectives tells us a negative feeling?
Miserable.
And
Disappointed. Disappointed.
that's right. Very good. Okay, what about excited and delighted? What do they
Excited.
mean?
Excited means that we are looking forward to something, and delighted means we are happy of something.
That is right. Very good. Can you think of a word that means the same with delighted?
Happy.
Happy. That's right. Very good, Pinky. All right. Now let's look at this one. So, I'm going to ask you to write a story again. So here's the beginning of your story. Matthew felt excited as he waited for the train. Okay, so look at the questions in here. Are you given a first line? Of course, you are given. Then number two, should you write in the first or the third person point of view? By just looking at the first line, so are you going to write in the first or the third person point of view?
Third.
Third, very good, because of he. Okay, so the keywords in here are, okay, excited, then waited for the train. So you know the drill, Pinky. You can write your answer and send it here in the chat box. And let me know once you're done. Take your time, Pinky.
7 minutes.
Sure.
Kilala ko siya ng totoo. I'm unfolding and you. Ay, ganda. Oh my God. Oh my God. Wow. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning, guys. Saan yung kapapunta na doon? Hindi ko makita. Sa yung dalawa lang nakikita. Sa yung pupunta, hindi. Papunta mo nga muna doon. Wait.
Okay, so let me read this one. Matthew felt excited as he waited for the train. When the train arrived, Matthew boarded the train. He was excited because he was going to visit his parents' house. But the train was so crowded and cramped that he had to squeeze to get on. 1 hour later, Matthew finally arrived at the city where his parents were. He happily went to his parents' house and was warmly welcomed. Oh, actually, very good composition of this story, Pinky. Okay. However, there is only one minor correction. Okay. In writing, okay, whatever you're writing, it could be a story, letter, you are sending an email. As long as it is informal, write. Formal writing in English, the name of the person should always be capitalized. Okay, so very good at first. Okay, Matthew. Okay, and the last Matthew in here should also starts with letter M. I of
Yes.
course, I mean it should starts with a big letter M. All
Yes.
right.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, but very good. You are doing great in creating the continuation of the story. Nice. All right. So let's look at this one. What's this? Okay. So this time, Pinky, you're going to think about the question that we have here in exercise two because you're going to plan your story, like your own story. Like last week and today, I gave you the first line of the story. So you were just adding the continuation of the story, but this time you have the full control of what story you want to write. Yes, Pinky.
So you can, you stop for with me for 5 minutes?
Okay, sure.
Teacher, I'm in right now.
All right. So going back, Pinky, now, you're going to make your own story. So if you can remember last week and earlier, I asked you to continue I mean, to make the continuation of the story. So I only gave you the beginning sentence of the story, but now you have the full control. So here, you decide where and when to set your story. You plan the main events and think about the kind of person that your main character is. Then try to make your story interesting for your readers. Okay, so how much time do you need to make your story, Pinky? Don't forget to also include a title for your story. All right.
I think I have 10 minutes.
Okay, sure. Take your time, Pinky. No pressure. Hi, Pinky. Everything okay?
Yes.
Oh, yes. Yeah, I actually you left and I just saw you coming back. Okay, did you start writing your story yet? Oh, here it is. All right, so let me read this one. Mary's friend's birthday was last Monday. When the time was almost up, Mary was on her way to the train station. When she arrived, she missed the train and couldn't make it to her best friend's birthday. Mary was very sad and she burst into tears right away. Surprisingly, Mary's best friend passed by and saw Mary crying. She immediately went over and took Mary with her. Mary was very happy to see her friend, and they both went home and had a grand birthday party. Very good. Okay, so this is actually a well-written story, Mary. I'm Pinky. Okay, but I just want to remind you that in writing, a paragraph is composed of 3 to 5 sentences. So if we're going to look at this one, so 1, 2, 3. Okay. So after when she arrived, she missed the train and couldn't make it to her best friend's birthday. So make it separate it into another paragraph. So you go down to another paragraph. Mary was very sad like that. Okay, 3 to 5. Or you can count. Let me see. 3. This is 3, 4, 5. 6, 7. All right. But it's okay. This is also considered. So well done for that one, Pinky. Okay, so any question about creating a story? It's very easy to create a story, right?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so what are the important factors in making a story, Pinky? We should have a character. Okay, what else?
Imagine
Say that again.
a character, situation.
Yes, situation. Very good. What else?
An idea, I think.
Yeah, idea, the setting of the story, what's wrong in the story, like that, the main events. Okay, so very good. And also describe the feeling of your character or describe the personality of your character. So since we're done with this one, we are going to move on with this is unit 6. Okay, so if you hear the phrase television programs, Mary, so what comes into your mind?
Comedy.
Comedy, very good. What else?
Cartoons.
Cartoons, that's right, very good. So, what is your favorite television program?
I think it is Disney Channel or oh, I think the cartoons named Teen Titans Go because I love it very much.
Okay. So, wow, I am happy because you also have a Disney Channel. Yes, that is actually the channel that I used to watch when I was like in primary school.
Me too.
Yes. Oh, wow. So what other cartoon channels do you have in your country? Pinky, do you have Cartoon Network or
Yes.
Disney Junior?
In recent months, Disney has stopped working in Vietnam, so I just watched Cartoon Network.
Oh, yes. So, wow. What about Animal Planet? Do you have that one?
I know, but I don't watch that.
Okay, but is it included in your network or in the different channels that you guys have?
Yes.
Oh, wow. So, yeah, it's almost similar to our channels here in the Philippines too. Okay, so let's look at the different television programs in here. So first we have here.
Advert.
Advert.
Very good. So what does advert mean, Pinky?
It is an introduce program, I think, on TV to advertise their product so that people can buy.
That is right. Very good. So the keyword is advertise, just like what you said. So, advert is for promotion. They are going to promote something to the public or to announce something to the public. Just like this one, Skittles. Have you ever tried this candy, Skittles?
Yes, and I like it.
Yes, very good. So yes, once they would show an advertisement about Skittles, then children would say, "Oh wow, how does it taste?" So they would be very interested to buy one. Okay, then we have your second, your favorite, we have cartoon. Okay, so what was the title of cartoon that you like, Pinky?
The
Oh.
Amazing World of Gumball and Teen Titans Go.
Oh yes, I'm familiar with the Titans Go. Yeah, because of my nephew.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Then we have in here chat show.
Just so.
Chat show. Very good. So it's very clear from its from the word chat show. Okay, so it's like you are in a show, then someone is asking questions about you. Yeah, if you are an influencer, so they will ask some personal questions or what your fans want to know more about you. Like that. That is a chat show. It's just like an interview. Okay, now Advert,
let's look at this one.
cartoon,
Oh,
chat
I'm
show,
sorry. So we have here
comedy series.
comedy series.
Very good. Give me an example of comedy series in Vietnam or even in the Hollywood.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I just know some things that it is funny, and I don't know some comedy series.
All right. Okay, but you know comedy series, right? So what's the difference of a comedy movie and a comedy series, Pinky?
Comedy movies means it is it's just like a movie that which lasts about 1 hour to 2 hours. And comedy series is a show is shown by many episode, I think.
That's right. Very good. So a comedy movie only lasts for 1 or 2 hours, while a comedy series, it is composed of many seasons, and every season it has many episodes. Yes. All right. So from the word comedy, that means it is funny. It makes you laugh. All right. Then we also have a cooking show. All right. Do you like cooking
Cooking
show,
show.
Pinky?
Haven't watched the show before, so I don't know.
Okay. But you know what? Cooking show, it's not only on the television. Even in YouTube, you can actually watch cooking show. Yeah, like what's that? Many influencers do this one if they are food vloggers. Yes. Okay. So yeah, in the cooking show, of course, we learn how to cook a specific food. Yes, okay. Me, I like watching cooking shows so that I will learn how to prepare that food. And it also makes me hungry when I watch someone cooking.
Yes.
Okay, then we,
May I drink water? May I drink water?
Oh, sure.
Yes, thank you. Tisha, I'm back.
All right. Okay, so what were what where were we last time? All right. So we have here in the quiz show. Okay, so yes, we can see a quiz show on the television. Yes, it could be a single player or group of or it could be in groups like that. For example of this one is Family Feud.
What?
Yes. Okay. So that is a quiz show. So whoever gets the correct answers and whoever gets the highest score will win. And they get a prize. It could be a money or just what to or something that could be given to them. It could be a house, car, or whatever it is. But most of the time, it is money.
Quiz
Okay,
show.
then we have here next.
Reality show.
Reality show.
Yes. Okay, so what is reality show, Pinky?
It's just like a sing competition or the survive in the survival of many people in the level, I think.
That is right. Very good. Just like the one that you can see here, The Voice. Yes,
Yes.
or American Idol, The X Factor, Storage Wars. Okay, so those are famous reality show. So it is a type of television program that actually features real life situations. It could be with ordinary people or celebrities. Yes, just like One Direction. Have you ever heard about that band, Pinky?
Yeah.
Yes, One Direction before they became famous. Okay, they came from the X Factor. Or I'm not sure.
Yes.
Like I think X Factor, American yeah, X Factor or The Voice where they auditioned. That's why they were I mean, that's where they started before they become famous. Yeah, so most of the singers starts from the reality show. Like singing competition, they will have an audition like that. Okay, and lastly we have here
Sports.
Sports.
very good. So of course you already know what sports is. Yeah, so anyway, Pinky, that's it for tonight. Then we'll continue next week. So thank you so much for showing up today, Pinky. I hope you learned something and see you next week. Have a great day, Pinky.
Goodbye, teacher.